I hate it because I, the thing is with my keyboard, when I want to switch the viewers, I have to like go to 2 and 0. God damn it.
Control initialize.
And I can't use the numpad. You bastard. Oh man. Oh come on. Oh god, get the autocorrect, whatever. Yeah. So now on my number two hotkey we have Lord Ever, currently named as Donkey in the beautiful brown brownish color with the gray background in the name, which makes it just absolutely horrific. He's gonna play against Sir Kick-a-Lot, the host himself on the Aquarius. We just saw this map with Netnaz Ghoul and Point One, I believe it was. This time it's gonna be a Russia versus England, okay. So a Soviet versus Allied matchup. A little bit different this time around. Good stuff. Good stuff. Gustafa. And yeah, we're just gonna have to see exactly how Lord Ever deals with this map. It's again, it's very it's not something that covers to his strength. I mean, obviously you do have Naval, but also like even if you go for Naval and you're good against it, you might just pick like the other side, which and pick or just pick like two sides each, and then not really engage each other, and then end up with like a tech game late game something like that. We shall see. These are Grenadiers, right? Yeah, Grenadiers, but they have to be hugging the sides or they're just gonna run into infantry. Oh my god, they just stopped right outside the line, right outside the Congo line. I can't believe that's so insane. They're just like they're literally one cell away from being spotted. They're like right here. I love that here. Oh no! Oh, that's so unfortunate. The Lord Ever sold off an ore refinery. He got this kind of batch of infantry now. These are not, well, they might actually kill off this power plant. They're gonna keep on the move. One more throw! There we go. Beautiful. Lord Ever, look at how long this MCV. Yeah, he had to cancel the war factory. The MCV was building the war factory in 1 minute, which is just disgusting. This was a huge deal for a Point One. Excuse me. I'm a retard. This is Sir Kick-a-Lot. Sorry about that. So Lord Ever is in trouble here. I mean, Lord Ever isn't a fantastic player, but it's not like you can just play. You can't really have a superb comeback against the top players in RA. Sir Kick is one of the one of the good ones. And he will be able to take advantage of a superior position, even against players such as the Lord Ever. So Sir Kick-a-Lot definitely in the lead here, like far in the lead. There's a surface depot, 3 harvesters, and he's building now an hijacker. Jesus Christ, that could be dangerous. But there's no way for the hijacker to come in. Like Lord Ever has control of all the paths into this base, including the island. So this hijacker is really useless, unless it's being used for spotting. You know, you should expect Lord to have control of this area. There is the war factory for Lord Ever. My god, it is so late. It is just absolutely crazy. He's building a ranger, which I'm not sure that he wants to do, but maybe he feels like he has no choice. He needs to kind of get out there and scout a little bit. Meanwhile, like, Sir Kick-a-Lot, he might just want to just expand around and find a way. Wow, all this infantry is kind of moving ahead of the APC, which is kind of a mistake. Oh, never mind. Oh, it just went ahead right before the rifle infantry engagements. It's pretty rough. Yeah, man. So these two paths are not like you can't cross over here, so. You basically have this kind of weird long paths around the middle. It's like twin paths kind of thing. Oh my god, that's how obviously how he's gonna get his hijacker in. But there are quite a few infantry and the rangers here, so this is not really gonna do anything. I think, unless he kind of drops one over here or something like that. Oh, he's gonna drop him over here, maybe. Probably not a bad idea. Yeah, man. Rangers. Ranger danger. Okay, they seize the APC, so this is not a problem. Ranger's gonna deal with this. Oh no! He got the ore truck! He got the ore truck. And if he gets... I'm not sure if it's gonna get... No, it's not gonna get home with it. And you know what? Lord Ever, yeah, it's gonna be the mechanic here. See, it's gonna capture this this back. So Lord is okay. Lord is okay. Well, as okay as it can be. So I mean, this house should be alive for enough time to get the back. Good stuff. Ortruck is back in the game. That was so important. If Lord would have dropped Ortruck, I would be tempted to say it's game. That would, yeah, I don't know, that would be game for sure. Like, that would just be absolutely horrific. It would just blow my mind how horrific that would be. Support your allies. Sir Kikot is moving up an MCV. It's gonna base push this time around. And I think, like, why not? I mean, you could just do that. Oh, okay, now it's just gonna deploy there to get the flame turret up. Wow, I can't believe I got 2 subscribers to the channel. That's making me really proud. I never really thought people were going to subscribe to the channel. I got the affiliate like a couple of weeks ago, and I was just thinking, like, well, I guess, like, what other advantages is there to being a Twitch affiliate? You do get some kind of advantages when on bandwidth, stuff like that. But like the Twitch sub thing is just giving you like extra cash every month. It's kind of funny, and I love it. All right, so we have a submarine here. You can see the 2 slots on the submarine. I haven't really seen it yet, but you can actually bring it to the coast, and you can actually get 2 infantry into these submarines. So you might see that. We might not. I'm not. Yeah, this is actually Sir Kakelot. So he knows about this. Oh, hijackers inside the submarine. What the hell? Wow. And, you know? Oh, wow. It's going to work. It's going to definitely work. This pillbox is not covering this this right side. And this little drop-off. I wonder if the... I didn't see... I don't think the submarine had to resurface for the infantry to get in there. So you can just kind of... stay there and just pop out this twin. Oh my god. Oh wow! Oh my god, these are so strong. I mean, rocket soldiers are obviously strong, but the Rangers get them right next to the Tesla coils, loses 1 or 2 immediately, but it just kills them both. So it lost the Rangers, but the infantry is actually what you want to keep alive. The Rangers are okay. I mean, they cost like 500. It's not that big of a deal. Okay, here we go. Okay, it does have to resurface to... Oh! It gets into range of the pillbox, though. This is one. And... Oh, Lord Diver's gonna save both. That's so good. That's so good by Lord Diver. He needs, like, every... Lord Diver cannot afford, like, 1 bad engagement whatsoever. He kind of lost the Rangers there, but he killed off 2 Tesla coils at the same time. So that was kind of okay, but... on the whole, he cannot really do anything bad in this game, like not one single thing for him to come back. Like, other, if he also get this island back, like he definitely would be back in the game. And I don't see Sir Kakelot going for the tech right now. Because in the flag trap, you can kind of see the icon image up here. It's pretty sick. I see blue water. Oh, it's actually tech center first for... I mean, the tech center is going to come up first for Lord Driver. That's pretty important. These pillboxes are... Okay, now they're starting to focus fire. And this is going to probably stop this attack. There's going to come in behind here. Enough infantry to stop this. The MCV is kind of in the... No, it's okay. Lori's gonna kill off the rocket soldiers and the MCV should just be okay. Now it's gonna move it back. Oh. Oh. Well, it does have mechanics though. This doesn't look, this isn't too bad actually. Mechanics gonna come in and take it back. No problem. No problem. Texter is coming up for a circuit as well. So we do have the GPS timer for Lord Diver coming up here. Counting down and in the tech center for Soviet Russia. And we're going to have ourselves a tech game. As for naval, Sergei Kalat obviously took the control of the right side. Lori still has a chance to kind of go into the left side. But he might just avoid going for naval altogether because of this early loss. Why are Tesla coils so OP? Because you know, red alert, man. It's all about the Tesla coils. It's an iconic part of the game. You need those OP Tesla coils. If those Tesla coils were just like meh, then you lose the soul of open array. I mean red alert. Gotta have some OP units, you know. A subs are awesome. Yeah, they're pretty cool. This right here. Flak trap. Wow, look at big at it. It's so huge. It's enormous. It's like two, you know. It looks like just a increased size missile submarine. Maybe it is exactly that, I'm not sure. But it did build a missile submarine, so we might see a harassment here by Sir Cake. I don't like the position for this tech center though. It's like it's right next to the beach, and it's gonna be spotted right now. Not right now, but it's gonna be spotted probably from Sir. That's a lot of heavy tanks. I don't think Lord ever will expect that, but he's got this line so well up. There's no infantry behind this. This is just a donation by Sir K-Cloud. It's gonna give away freaking 6 heavy tanks. And if Lord Driver wants to, he can capture all of them. 5 of them just donated for free. That was so unnecessary. Sir K-Cloud, what he needs to do is not attack in here with 6 heavy tanks. He gave up. He did not like this. Yeah, okay, so he did maybe see the expansion on the island as well. I was thinking like maybe that was premature, but I think that was just because what Turkey could do is obviously just go and grab all the sea, spam out all the subs and missile subs and whatever he wants to, and just harass absolutely everything. It would be beautiful, but he went for the army route, and he just got in here into the choke, lost the heavy tanks. And lost his morale. So that's was it for this game. Pretty insane. Pretty crazy. Fun game though.
Battle control terminated.